and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthems of the Democratic and Popular Republic of Algeria and the United States of America.
Thank you. President, this concludes the honors.
Concerns about Middle East peace, North African stability, and African economic development and political process, or progress, I should say, are among items which I look forward to discussing with you. Through these discussions, we seek the relations which exist in the early days of your independence. Your visit gives us an opportunity to further strengthen our bilateral ties. In this respect, I note with satisfaction that we will see between the United States and Algeria moving in a positive direction, and there are only two of the areas in which our interests coincide and are growing. Your visit should serve as the canvas for further friendship-building activities between our peoples and governments. The United States is already one of Algeria's. I look forward to spending this time with you and our discussions on matters of importance to both of us. Mr. President, we greet you as a friend.
التي وجدتوها إلينا وعلى حفاوة هذه الأرض الطيبة التي وحدت بنا رجال جاءوا من مختلف أرجاء الأرض وبنت فيهم أمة عظيمة.
Mr. President, thank you for your warm welcome and for the quality of the reception given to both my delegation and myself upon our arrival. I should also like to express the pleasure that I feel coming for the first time to this rich land that has brought together people from all lands into one great nation, to bring a message of friendship and respect from the Algerian people to the American people.
أن الشعب الجزائري يعرف حق المعرفة بأنه أقرب يكون إلى المبادئ التي قامت من أجلها الثورة الأمريكية وقال في المسيرة التاريخية نحو انتزاع الحريات. كما يذكر كذلك العلاقات التي تأسست في وقت مبكر بين بلدينا مباشرة بعد استقلال الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية إلى إقامة الحوار مع بلدكم إلى الاحترام المتبادل. واستطيع أن نقول بأن هذا الحوار أتاح لنا على مر السنين أن نعرف بعضنا البعض بشكل أفضل وأن ندرك الانشغالات الخاصة بكل واحد منا في مواجهة تحديات عصرنا الحاضر.
It is only natural that once it had regained its sovereignty, Algeria dedicated itself.
استفادت منه حقا اقتصاديات كل من بلدين ولا يخالجنا أدنى شك في أن هناك إمكانيات لتنمية تعاون نشيط بين الجزائر والولايات.
Through cooperation and trade, the United States and Algeria have undoubtedly experienced benefits to both our economies. It is undeniable that my country is strongly committed to the ideals of the goal of the United Nations to achieve peace and development for all the nations of this world.
وإنه لمن الثابت في هذا النطاق أن التنمية والسلام تقوم بينهما علاقات وسيلة فالهدف من وراء شعار الرخاء المتضامن المتبادل ويسعدني ويستند إلى حقيقة الترابط القائم بين الأمم.
It is an established fact in this context that progress called for by the non-aligned countries is founded on the principle of mutual interdependence and upon a quest for a world of peace and
progress.
provinces accumulate and areas of tension multiply, there is more than ever an urgent need for the international community to Algeria believes that and as long as these capabilities other than that of dissension and poverty. And thank you, Mr. President.
President, does the Pope support aid to the Contras?
Now, you know I'm not supposed to answer questions here, but He has been most supportive of all of our activities in Central America.
Military aid to the Contras as well?
I'm not going to go into details. As I said, all our activities.
Congressman Michael suggested that a compromise would be necessary to get Contra aid approved. Is that a compromise in the works?
Thank you. No questions. Lights, please.
This gives me a chance, in addition to the pleasure of welcoming you, it gives us an opportunity to express the gratitude of our people for Algeria's role in getting the return of our hostages from Tehran. And we appreciate very much your continuing efforts with regard to the people of ours who are being held hostage now in Lebanon. I know you must have an agenda here. I would just like to say, however, that one of our top priorities is to help move the peace process in the Middle East into direct negotiations based on United Nations Resolution 242. Well, again, we said welcome. Let me welcome again you and all of your colleagues here. We're extremely pleased to have you here. We recognize your role in North African affairs. The Western Sahara dispute, we know, threatens regional stability. And we agree that this problem should be resolved by the parties involved in the regional context. We hope that there will be continued efforts to achieve an acceptable solution directly with the Moroccans. And I would like to ask, having asked you a question about another area there, how you see the Western Sahara situation.
الواقع بشكل الصحراء الغربية يكون تطرق إلى تاريخ القضية كنا نعرف لكن الواقع الشيء اللي نريد أن نتطرق إليه بالنسبة لقضية الصحراء بالنسبة لنشاطها في المجال الدولي كان رئيس حكومة القديمة مع مساندات